goes back up to 140, where he may have been earlier this week before he got the last-minute notice to take the fight, and Mayweather has gained 6 pounds. They're equal in reach. Punch stat numbers, Larry.
Juuko is a very, very active fighter, throws a lot of punches, but that means that he's also a very hittable fighter because he doesn't land a very high percentage of them. He primarily throws that jab out there one every 3 seconds, according to these numbers. Sooner or later, Mayweather is going to be able to time it.
Rules of the bout with our unofficial ringside scorer, Harold Lederman.
The Floyd Mayweather Justin Juuko fight is scheduled for 12 rounds. Using those unified rules of the Association of Boxing Commissions, there is no standing 8 count, no 3 knockdown rule. Only the referee can stop the fight, and you cannot be saved by the bell in any round, including the 12th and final round.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening, and welcome to the fabulous Mandalay Bay Resort Casino here in Las Vegas, Nevada, where tonight Bob Arum's Top Rank Incorporated, the Las Vegas Hilton, and the Mandalay Bay, along with your undisputed, undefeated king of beers, Budweiser, this Fuzz for you, present an evening of world championship boxing. Sanctioned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission and the World Boxing Council. Before we continue, on behalf of Top Rank Incorporated, belated birthday wishes to the greatest matchmaker in boxing history, Hall of Famer Teddy Brenner. The officials appointed for this bout at ringside are WBC Supervisor Mr. Frank Quill. The three judges scoring the contest on a 10-point must system will be Anek Hamtonkan, John Keane, and Daniel Fondavilla, and your referee in charge of the action when the bell rings, Mitch Halpern. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the Mandalay Bay Resort Casino of Las Vegas, 12 rounds of boxing for the WBC Super Featherweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black, red, and yellow, and weighing 130 pounds. His professional record, an excellent one. 33 victories with 25 knockouts, only 2 defeats, and 1 draw. Ladies and gentlemen, from Masaka, Uganda, here is the challenger, the Ugandan Destroyer, Justin Juuko. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black trimmed with silver, weighing in at 130 pounds also. His professional record stands at a perfect 20 victories without a defeat, including 15 knockouts. And already, at this early stage of his career, he is regarded among the best as pound for pound, one of the best in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, from Grand Rapids, Michigan, presenting the reigning and defending undefeated WBC Super Featherweight Champion of the World, Pretty Boy Floyd Mayweather.
All right, gentlemen, let's keep discipline, obey my commands at all times, test against good luck.
Given all the violence that's been going on in the world since you lost at a prize fight, it's nice to be just doing a little old boxing match.
Justin Juuko was to be trained tonight by the respected trainer Freddie Roach. But Freddie Roach has another assignment simultaneously working down in Mexico with Johnny Tapia, who's preparing for a championship fight. This morning, Freddie Roach worked Tapia out and then apparently missed his scheduled flight here to Las Vegas. So Juuko works tonight without the trainer he's accustomed to in his corner. Ruben Gomez, the cut man, becomes the chief second in that corner. And George, that's got to be the
It's awful difficult because you don't know, you need your motor to kind of crank it, crank things up. You don't have the trainer, you don't know when, what, and how to get started. So he's going to have some problems, especially in the first couple of rounds, if the fight can last that long with this left jab keep popping around over here.
Mayweather is just really throwing a hard jab at Juuko, landed 5 or 6 already.
And Juuko, who has been throwing in previous bouts upwards of 70 or 80 punches per round, won't approach that output number in this first round against Floyd Mayweather. It's hard to throw a lot of punches against a super-fast opponent like Floyd.
Floyd has a convenience. He loves to watch punches pass him by, make you miss. Can't seem to function without it.
Hard left hook. You can see that Floyd Mayweather can do so much off the front foot. He jabs beautifully. He has a quick lead left hook. He can follow with right hands over the top.
Juuko on the win this boxing match. He's got to get wild a little bit. He can't just stay right there on the standard boxing. Move your right foot a little closer to your left foot so that you can hit him with your right hand. Sometimes the right foot is too far away. It's going to make you farther away when you throw the right hand. That was a good left jab to the chest.
Good counter left hand by Juuko. Just misses with the right hand over the top. Juuko looks quite relaxed in there and is starting to get off a little bit now in the second half of the round.
You have a fight already planned. You're going to the training camp for a tough fight. Then all of a sudden you switch to your opponents. That can really throw you off. So Mayweather's having to adjust a little bit too.
Mayweather said he was in no way surprised that Gregorio Vargas dropped out of the bout. He said that when first he saw Vargas in a publicity outing for the bout a couple of weeks ago, Vargas looked to him like he weighed 160 pounds. And he was thinking, how is this guy possibly going to fight me?
Vargas was thinking the same thing at that time.
How am I going to fight this guy? Mayweather said at first he didn't even realize that Vargas was the opponent because he looked in no way like what an opponent for a 130-pound world championship fight ought to look like that short a period of time before the bout. Cautious workmanlike first round for Floyd Mayweather Jr. Justin Juuko throwing about half as many punches as has been the case against lesser opponents.
Juuko showed perhaps a little bit too much respect for Mayweather in the first round. He wanted to see what he had, and so he's hardly throwing that left jab. Let's see if he steps it up here.
Mayweather with a quick snapping overhand right to start out round number two.
No way looking. He's just waiting for the jab to come over the top. Mayweather.
Juuko pounding to the body with a wide right.
Mayweather's trying to look to get in the pocket now. He's been outside enough. Mayweather would like to slip those punches and be a little closer to his opponent. That's what he's doing now. He's not jumping far away now.
Good left hook to the body by Mayweather landed.
That's when you can roll the punches when you stay in the pocket. When you jump far away, the guy can't hit you, but nor can you return the punch.
And as you start to get closer to your opponent and try to set up farther inside, it's always good to pound him to the body a couple of times to take the aggressiveness away.
Now he's going to be very smart with body punches because he's fighting a quick guy. When you reach down there too much, then he can get something else.
So he'll use them selectively.
Selectively, that's a great word to say. He's looking at just to get closer, closer, closer. When you do something, you gotta look at your opponent's shoulders. Now, Juuko's got some big shoulders for that weight class. It's not like he's not gonna have something when he throws a punch.
He's also showing more defense than we were led to believe. According to Jeff Mayweather, who had sparred so often with him, that he had told Floyd that he throws so many hard punches that you can time him and he does have a lot of holds. So Juuko here is perhaps aware of that relationship between the uncle and the nephew, and he is throwing fewer punches, being more resourceful.
And maybe he's pacing himself that way too, because he faded in the late rounds of his preceding bout, an 11th round TKO loss to Antonio Hernandez, in which Juuko was leading on two scorecards at the time at which the fight was stopped. And so it's in his best interest to try to save something for the later rounds against Floyd, who for his part believes, based on what Uncle Jeff and Floyd Sr. have told him, that Juuko will fade after a faster early pace.
I think what has happened is like a guy duck hunting. He's just waiting. You gotta wait
you can't hit anything. And you find yourself waiting too long. This guy's so fast, dynamic. You think you're gonna miss, I'm gonna miss this, so I'm just gonna wait for a good shot.
Right hand over the top lands for Juuko.
Get up, come on.
Second round, not a bad one.
Did make that clear.
It is.
Yeah, Oscar did make it clear that, in his view, certain people are leaving the Delaware boat after this particular voyage.
Part of his new transformation, he says he wants to cut his team down from about 20 to 4.
Knockbox numbers showing that Justin Juuko is getting a little bit more comfortable. He only landed 3 punches in the first round, but landed 11 in round 2, and actually threw 4 more punches than Floyd Mayweather. Floyd doesn't try to throw 65, 70 punches around. He's pretty measured in his output.
He's seen the rewards of being a puncher, so he believes that he can take you out any time.
Good punch by Mayweather, just a little bit high.
More and more, it looks as though that quick counter right hand over the top of Juuko's jab is the primary item in the recipe for tonight.
Kind of lows you a little bit. He doesn't do anything for a couple of minutes, and all of a sudden he unloads with something that shocks you. It makes you think you're slipping, but you're not slipping, you're hurt.
Mayweather blocking or partially blocking all of Juuko's shots here. Juuko glancingly lands the right hand over the top, but Mayweather to do a lot of damage, and then Mayweather lands the right hand counter.
Mayweather's found the pocket now. He's not stepping and jumping back. He's getting closer, and that's what you don't want to happen. But Juuko is best start moving and jabbing a bit more to throw him off rhythm.
And you saw Floyd step right up in Juco's face, wait for him to throw the left hand, and then pop the right.
Yeah, well, what is happening to you, Juuko now should start jabbing and moving out of the way, make him reestablish the pocket somewhere else. And step back a little bit and make him change. Juuko can very well win. He doesn't think I can win this thing too. It's an opportunity. Sometimes you can get into a fight with a fast, classy guy like Mayweather and start looking just like the audience, forgetting that you came here to win.
Again, the right-hand counter over the top. Mayweather dropping and splitting his hands from time to time, try to invite Juuko to come in.
Juuko best start moving around, do something, just to change things up and make Mayweather reach at him a little bit and miss.
And that's exactly what Jeff Mayweather told his nephew that Juuko would do. That he would do the same thing round after round, and he would give Floyd a chance to time it.
Jim, 3-0, 30-27, Floyd Mayweather Jr. Jim, I'm going to tell you something. What I love about him is, you know, we always talk about ring generalship. In the first round, Mayweather had Justin Juuko looking for left jab, and then he gave him that variety. He started throwing right-hand leads. In the second round, he switched to southpaw. He threw left hooks underneath. So he's showing Juuko such a variety. Juuko just doesn't know what to look for, and that's great ring generalship. The judges have to consider that. Yeah.
Mayweather landing a little left hook inside, missing with the right as Juuko backed away. Now Juuko getting more aggressive, and Floyd gets a chance to crack him. Two right hands.
That last right hand might have gotten Mayweather's attention a little bit, but it also gets him riled up to land his own.
You got to learn in this weight division, especially Mayweather's, you just can't let those guys hit on you, especially around your side and your body. The fight goes on 5-6 rounds, the energy that you thought you had already evaporated. He's allowed him to jab him in his chest now. No, you don't need that.
Jab in the chest, jab in the belly. Good, hard, digging left hook to the body by Mayweather. Juuko comes back with a right-hand shot to the body himself.
All right.
Mitch Halperin says keep him up.
Boy,
right uppercut just a tiny bit short.
I like everything that Mayweather's doing, but allowing himself to be hit around the side and chest is not good.
Like that?
He looks at him as though he's waiting for Juuko to do something so he can counter it. In the meantime, he sometimes allows himself to be hit.
If the fight goes beyond six rounds, then those little punches count up. Juuko is solid. He's not the best, but he's solid at what he does.
Mayweather has got so much talent, you know, so much zest for the game, and it's just a question of how he's going to win this fight rather than whether he is going to win this fight.
And when you're a solid fighter like that, you get thrown out four or five rounds, you can really pick up things in the six, seven rounds. That's where you beat talented fighters. Let them use their talent against themselves.
Tonight on HBO's World Championship Boxing, you're looking at two of the very best pound-for-pound fighters in the sport, Floyd Mayweather in this bout, Oscar De La Hoya, later to come this evening. For round number four, Floyd Mayweather landing nearly 60%, 22 out of 38. But Justin Juuko much more active, throwing 61 punches and landing 21. So Juuko's beginning to make a fight of it now against Mayweather as we go to the fifth.
Juuko jumps off his corner. His eyes are not dim. His spirit is still up. That's not good for Mayweather.
You know, looking at him, I can't help but think of his countryman, John Mugabe, who gave Marvin Hagler one of the best fights of Hagler's career here in Las Vegas back in the 80s. If they've come over from Uganda and they've made a professional life here, they must have a lot of toughness to begin with.
After you've devastated a guy in the fashion Mayweather's done early on, his eyes should be looking to the floor. He should be watching his corner men to see how he feels, but that has not happened to him.
Now, this is a terrific opportunity. First of all, he's making more money by far than he's ever made in his life, a recorded $75,000. And it's a terrific opportunity to get exposure, and if he makes a good showing, we could see him again. So he's got all the motivation in the world, and if he loses, well, he's taking the fight on 3 days' notice.
Some of the people who worked to help Gregorio Vargas get the chance to fight in this fight were infuriated that he chose to drop out on such short notice, and one of them even piped up and said, I hope he never gets a chance like that again. Meanwhile, I think the consensus of experts at ringside would be that Juuko is probably a tougher opponent for Mayweather at this moment in his career.
This fight has turned. I want you to know this fight has turned already. While we were doing all the talking,
yep,
it's a different fight already. Mayweather's
getting comfortable.
Yep. And he's been able to get in some of those shots, and it's because of the earlier body punching.
Now Floyd Mayweather rocks him back with a right hand. And Floyd, who was able to finish against Angel Manfredi with the help of a questionable stoppage down in Florida, looks for a moment to try to do the same against Juuko, but then goes back into the pocket and gets back to business.
He's got to understand, Mayweather, if you get an opportunity to get a knockout, you better do it. You can't play with these guys. And Juuko better take advantage of his opportunity and may not come back in the next 2 rounds.
So you'd like to see both men be more aggressive right now?
Yeah, Juuko especially. Mayweather throws his right hand and does not come back with the left hook, and he gets caught every time.
Justin Juuko seems to be saying to Floyd Mayweather, if you're going to let me hit you in the body, I'm taking advantage of that. I will accept that invitation.
He's able to get closer and closer with that right hand on Mayweather already.
Mayweather doing a little bit of clowning and mugging for Juuko in there. But that was not a bad round for the former Ugandan fighter who now lives right here in Vegas.
Two more left hooks.
Somebody hears fighters say, no, daddy. Sounds like me at home. Now when Mayweather waits around and does nothing, this guy takes advantage of it. He'll take anything.
that little jab to the body if Mayweather keeps making it available.
And it helps. It helps.
Juuko doubling and tripling up on the jabs now. Mayweather still conscious of trying to land right-hand shots across the top of Juuko's left.
He is the memory of what his dad said to come back with the hook. He did it this time.
There it was. To the body.
You got to come back, finish up with the hook to get yourself back in position, number one. And then secondly, if the other shot has hit the guy, the other, this will finish him off. The left hook. You're gonna fight a style like Mayweather, you can't go to a party ever. Kept in training all year round.
Wait,
you cannot be, you cannot have a party in your life until your career is over.
Well, Larry, when you live in Las Vegas, that's not very likely, George.
It better be.
Well, Mayweather's father spent 3.5 years in prison for drug possession, but virtually everybody around Floyd agrees that when Floyd Sr. came out of the big house last year,
right hand,
that stabilized Mayweather's personal life and kept him from messing around too much.
Now, we're so old, a solid, stable community in Las Vegas. The people here are real solid.
Mayweather landing more power shots in this round. And looking as though he's beginning to try to break Juuko down technically.
Now, it seems to be he's enforced his wheel on Juuko now. Turn the tide again. Now, Juuko is waiting while Mayweather is waiting. Beforehand, when Mayweather would wait, he would do something.
Four shots to the body by Juuko.
This is when you say to yourself when you're fighting someone like Mayweather, man, strictly man. Nothing else.
Against Antonio Hernandez, or the lesser opponents Juuko was fighting before, yet another to try it against a guy like Floyd Mayweather. Harold, how do you have it 2-6?
Jim, 5 rounds to 1. 59-55, Floyd Mayweather. Jim, I'm gonna tell you something. Justin Juuko has never seen a fighter with a variety of punches like this kid has had, and that's what's killing him. Floyd wins, and he lands solid. You don't know what he's going to throw. Beautiful double left hooks. Right hand leads it. That right hand leads it. The sixth round really took the guys out of. Incidentally, Mitch Harper rightly has warned Justin Juuko 4 times already for low blows.
None of which seem to be terribly low.
No, I don't think so either. Juuko, if you want to win this fight, man, you got to get active. Just can't see how I went the distance with Mayweather and think you earned something.
Juuko misses with a right over the top, and Mayweather comes back with a right uppercut. And that sets off this flurry.
Mayweather's game takes a lot of condition
because
he still has the snap in his left jaw. Bounces whenever he wants, and he's taking a lot of body shots. And his eyes are his best weapon.
George, he's 22 years old.
Yeah, but I know a lot of guys who's 19 can't do this. Age is not, it's not about age. Watch this. Stands right on the ball and on your mark. That's what you want a fighter to do. You say to yourself, get on your mark, just like a track runner. On your mark, get set. He's doing it. He's standing right on the mark.
And right hand leads and left hooks have backed Juuko up and put Floyd totally in command of this 7th round. Now Juuko lands a big right hand over the top. and Floyd sticks his tongue out at us.
That was hurt, that's why.
He baited him into that punch. He was saying, come on, come on. Left himself open, got a straight right hand.
Juuko may not be the best one, but he's solid. He's not going to disappear and stop throwing punches.
The product of getting hit by all those hard right hands and left hooks that Floyd Mayweather delivered.
You know what I'm wondering is, where's Mayweather landed some beautiful left jabs early in the fight. He's going back to it right now, but it hasn't been there. He could use that left hand and work off that, but he doesn't seem to like to do that.
No, he's not a jabber. He has a good jab, but that's not his thing. He likes to get real close, watch the guy drop his hand or so, and take advantage of it.
Because, as you said, George, he has those amazing eyes and quick reflexes.
Some guys just throw shots whether they can see it or not. Now they do it because they're trained to do it. But this guy actually watches it like an airline pilot. One of those bombers, guys flying those fast planes. Juuko can still pull this thing out. All I do is go to the body for a while, get this guy to drop his hands and relax, and then go back upstairs for a while.
I love your optimism, George.
Because he's landed the body punches to do as much.
Well, maybe you're right.
But I mean,
we're getting into the last third of the fight.
Floyd Mayweather putting a little more mustard on his power punches now and rounding them out a little more as he tries to fulfill his father's prophecy that he can get Juuko out of it.
Mayweather's one of those guys, you know, they sign him to a football contract early on as a rookie, and then they don't give him what they want right off, he's going to have trouble later on. So this guy, he's a star, you better pay him.
If you tuned in late, you've read your program guide, and you're wondering which guy is Gregorio Vargas, he isn't here. He dropped out of the fight on Wednesday, and the gentleman in the striped trunks is Justin Juuko, a brave last-minute throw-in who is fighting well and giving Floyd Mayweather some competition, albeit falling short of winning rounds against Mayweather, who is dominating the bout.
This is the opportunity that you want, to fight a great champion, and he expects you not to be in shape. You take the fight on a short notice, and you get in there and upset him. That's what every fighter wants.
Well, Juuko has already won his battle for at least some respect, taking a fight, you know, 72 hours before the fight, hanging in there with an extraordinarily gifted fighter.
Another give and take flurry to end the eighth. Justin Juuko isn't gone yet.
Well, we're seeing an abundant display of Mayweather's many talents, but he hasn't been able to dramatize them with a stunning victory here or in putting on some drama and theater for us. You think that hurts him at all, George?
It really doesn't help things. You want to go out there, you say you want a lot of money, you say you deserve it, give us something. And this tonight, give us a knockout, a clean knockout, and maybe we'll buy a stock.
Well, it certainly gave the boxing public everything it could have hoped for in his tremendous performance against Genaro Hernandez and his stunning second-round TKO of Angel Manfredi. But then he went the distance with Carlos Rios in a tune-up bout prior to this one, and now there's every chance he might go the distance with Justin Juuko.
You know, there's absolutely nothing. Juuko is hurt by that right hand.
Just as I said, it might go the distance, of course. Floyd hammers Juuko with two right hands.
God!
And
six,
Mitch Hoffman counts.
Seven.
And Juuko doesn't look like he wants to go on.
That's.
He doesn't know where he is. It happens like that, Larry.
So once again,
he gave it to
Mayweather. Trumped us just as we were speculating.
I'm buying that stock.
On whether he could put a dramatic ending to this fight with a flourish.
Just as I said, a knockout is certain here and has been inevitable from the beginning of the fight.
Now that's when you want to go buy the stock. This guy's a star. I'm telling you, sign him up, pay him now, or pay for it later.
15 seconds ago, George, you were wondering whether it was a worthwhile stock, and here you are, you're in the bull market.
That's right. That's the way it goes.
That's what knockouts
do. That's the way it goes. A knockout will do it every time.
It only takes 15 seconds to knock a man out if you land the right punches, and he did.
Punches is the correct way to say it.
Boom.
Plural. He kept throwing.
Another look at Floyd Mayweather Jr.'s right hands that ended the bout. That was the second of two thunderous right hands. One, two.
That he didn't recover from right there.
Yeah, three.
That's it.
So there were three right hands that did it. And now let's go up to Michael Buffer for the official particulars on Floyd's victory.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mitch Halpern reaches the count of 10 at 1 minute 20 seconds of round number 9. The winner by knockout victory, still the undefeated WBC Super Featherweight Champion of the World, Pretty Boy Floyd Mayweather.
Couple of final comments on the bout. Take a look at punch stat numbers, and you can see that Justin Juuko threw 103 more punches, but landed 62 fewer, as Floyd Mayweather Jr., with his enormous hand speed, was able to land at a 54% rate.